Yeshiva World.
We're here by the kiva of Rabbi Yechia ben Aharon, a big tzaddik of Mekubo. And from here we're going to see a replica of the Beis HaMikdash HaSheni. It was actually used, and it is used for Hollywood scenes, and hopefully we could be mekadesh it and take it to a different level. And then, the reason why I'm wearing this beautiful jalabia is because we are going to try and attempt to go into the cave of Bnei Shlomo HaMelech. There's a legend here that they are buried in this area, about 2 hours away from here. And we are going to dress up as Arabs in order to not anger in any way the tribe that lives around this shrine. And B'siyata Dishmaya will be zeicha to be give a nachas ruach to the neshamas of the Bnei HaMelechim. So we are here, this is me and Moshe Geller, he has a schuss to be with me. We're going to be part of the mission of going to the shrine of the Bnei Shlomo HaMelech. And we're trying to be inconspicuous, as you could of course tell. And therefore, Siyata Dishmaya will be zeiche to go and say some Tehillim. We might be maybe perhaps the only group that ever did so, or at least for the past 100 years. And please daven for us, and we will daven for you. Thank you very much, and siyata dishmaya, we should see you very soon. So here we are, we're at the latest update. We made it all the way down after a long ride in a vadi. It means a very deep valley. And we shared with them some sheep. Here's Rabbi Lankwi offering one of the sheep to the tribe. The tribe, as you see, blocked the entrance to the Kevel of Ba'asa ben Shlomo. That's the Melech, the son of Melech Shlomo. If you look at the sign there, the ladies refused to move, and therefore we were probably not going to go in, but we're trying to make a Kiddush Hashem.
Make a circle.
I'm here in Morocco, as we said, and it's a little bit puzzling that we had to come to Morocco to see a replica, perhaps the closest replica of the Beis HaMikdash, by Sheni. And not perfectly accurate. First kasha is that instead of a ramp, there is steps. But it certainly gives us a little bit of a sense of what it means to feel them to be walking into an incredible edifice, an incredible place where the Shekhinah is supposed to reside, and we're supposed to connect to the Borei Olam.